start this course here because everything that you are experiencing right now can dictate how long your divorce goes, the level of conflict that you encounter, and what happens at the other end. Throughout the D course, I will give you many actionable items, but usually what you are emotionally experiencing is the place that puts you in the muck and prevents you from moving forward. It is so hard to talk about process and money and parenting schedules when you feel a little broken. It's hard. You will feel things and it's okay to grieve. In fact, you have to go through the stages of grief so that you can emerge ready to take on your new beginning. The Freedom Framework is a framework of what will happen during your divorce. At some point, you will have an internal conversation with yourself. You'll recognize when that happens now because I'm pointing it out, but most people don't identify this shift. This will be the point that sets you off in one direction or the other. The conversation you have with yourself stems from the emotional energy that you are experiencing. This moment will be a decisional threshold of how you come out the other end. If you choose one way, you will go into battle with your spouse. You will feel like he is always winning. You will feel like you are giving up too much. You will blame him. It may be your lawyer that you are not getting what you deserve or what you are entitled to. You will spend thousands and thousands of dollars on legal fees to make him pay for what he has done. You will end up with an agreement or a court order after a trial that you aren't happy with. You will still feel like your spouse got off easy, but it won't end there. The conflict will continue. The blame game will show up regularly. You will have a hard time moving forward. You'll be stuck. If you choose the other way, you will compromise and reach a decision that might not be perfect, but livable. You will accept that you grew apart, that neither of you are perfect, and that you are both entitled to be happy. Maybe you will mediate and keep your legal fees low so you have more money to spend on a new house or put into savings or your kids' college fund. You will forgive your spouse. And co-parenting after your divorce will be civil and respectful. You will both move on and meet new partners, perhaps. You will find new things that bring you joy, and you will be at peace where you are, even if it looks different than what you imagined. Let me illustrate this further. I have a client, and for purposes of this exercise, I'm going to call her Stephanie. Now, Stephanie, like most people, has a lot of anxiety about her divorce. The attitude she has adopted is, I won't recover from this. The questions she asks me sound something like this. How will I be able to pay my bills? How will I take care of the house maintenance? How will I ever trust again? You can see her questions are grounded in uncertainty. She is looking externally for answers. Let's compare this to you, because your attitude is not, I won't recover from this. Your attitude is, I will be okay. And the questions you ask are not, how will I? Your questions are, what can I do? What can I do to afford my bills? What can I do to make sure the driveway is plowed in the winter? What can I do to trust again? You are looking internally for solutions. See the difference? The Freedom Framework depends entirely on the energy you give these questions. You will have the opportunity to make this threshold decision over and over and over again throughout your divorce. The shift from looking to someone else to provide answers to looking inward to finding solutions will empower and embolden you to take control of your future.